This week's market movers: negotiations with Iran resume after presidential election, maintenance slows the bull run for US LNG exports, crude futures test two-year highs, and US product cracks ease as prices for renewable identification numbers slide. World Power has resumed another round of nuclear deal negotiations with Iran on June 20, a day after hardliner judiciary chief Ibrahim Raisi won presidential elections that could see the sanctioned OPEC producer seek to increase oil output this year. The US, under President Joe Biden, had hoped the talks, which included representatives from Russia, Germany, the UK, China, and France, could conclude before the Iranian elections. The indirect talks between Iran and the US in Vienna, which kicked off on April 9, have featured Iranian threats of further increasing uranium enrichment levels and a stalemate over implementation of the deal. Iran has insisted that the US relax sanctions first, since it unilaterally withdrew from the deal in 2018 under President Donald Trump, while the US wants Iran to return to full compliance with the JCPOA before earning sanctions relief. US feed gas utilization remained below the 10 BCF per day mark last week due to pipeline and facility maintenance taking place along the US Gulf Coast. An upcoming four-day maintenance to the Creole Trail pipeline, which supplies Cheniere Energy's Sabine Pass export terminal in Louisiana, will further reduce feed gas deliveries to the US's largest export facility, which has been operating around 1 BCF per day lower than normal. Deliveries to Sempra Energy's Cameron LNG facility, also in Louisiana, have also been down by around a train's worth of feed gas over the past 2 weeks, as the facility continues to undergo maintenance. This has resulted in a noticeable decline in the rate of US cargo loadings compared with previous months. So far for June, average US LNG export rates have clocked in at around 7.6 BCF per day, compared with 10 BCF per day in May, a record month for exports. The Americas crude complex experienced some of its strongest values in over 2 years last week as global fundamentals remain bullish. Front month, NYMEX WTI futures settled at just over $72 per barrel on June 16 and 17, the highest since October 2018. Crude futures have been mostly bullish since late October after crude values stagnated for months between $35 and $45 per barrel amid the coronavirus pandemic. Heightened per barrel costs have coincided with continued US upstream production returns. US oil and gas rigs jumped by 7 to 567 for the week ended June 16, according to rig data company Enverus. US refined product cracks moved sharply lower last week as prices for renewable identification numbers, or RINs, collapsed amid reports that the White House may ease some of the federal renewable fuel standard mandates. New York Harbor, RBOB, and heating oil cracks versus Brent, which have a RINs component baked in, were down around $3 in the week ended June 18, as RINs prices slid nearly 40% from all-time highs seen the week prior. Stay ahead of the evolution of energy at Platts Live, the new professional platform built exclusively for the energy industry. Have your say and join the conversation at PlattsLive.com. Once again, thank you for starting your Monday with us, and have a great week ahead.